Hello and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, I've gained a couple of subscribers from TikTok. I am Taz. I am a Sims 4 streamer over on Twitch and I sometimes upload to YouTube. Today, the Sims 4 Paranormal Stuff Pack has just come out, so I thought we would come on here and do a quick little haunted house build. Well, I don't know how quick it will be, but we'll give it a go. I also thought I would address the fact that Bonehilda is now in the game. She is looking as beautiful as ever. Let's show some muscles with Bonehilda. Bonehilda is freaking back, baby. She is back. She's back in action. She's in the game. She's sipping her drink of water. I'm excited. Are you? Ghosties are out. Oh my goodness. Hang on a minute. The ghosties are here. Pause. Pause. Hang on. Pause. Pause. The ghosties. Forget about Bonehilda. Ghosties. Look it. My goodness, I haven't seen this yet. I literally haven't seen this yet. Hang on. I was filming for TikTok before this, but I haven't seen this. Oh, he mad. He mad. Yeah, you clean that floor, Bonehilda. Let's get started on the video. Okay, so as the new Paranormal Stuff Pack has literally just come out, I wanted to come on and check out all the build buy items and make a haunted house. It has been a hot second since I made a haunted house. I actually had a look and I think it was 2019 the last time. So I thought the perfect time to make one again would be with the Paranormal Stuff Pack coming out. I did have a play around with the pack before I started making this video and I saw Bonehilda, I saw like the seances, the little green object things, obviously at the start of this video. It was really interesting actually. A lot of build buy items as well. I haven't looked at Creator Sim, so I'm not sure what comes in that. But no, I'm very excited for this and I think it will add a lot to the gameplay. Obviously I don't do a lot of gameplay myself, but it will be, it's an interesting one, especially with a paranormal investigator career as well. I haven't tried that out, but I'm intrigued to see how that works. So with this build, I kind of went for the usual look of using a lot of vampire objects and vampire wallpapers. I didn't go too clutter mad with this build and I kind of made it like into a basic sort of looking haunted house. As I just wanted to test out the new build items and do some sort of a build with them just to see how it works. I thought it looked not too bad, like it's not too shabby, but I did just want to make a little video and just see how it all works. So it's just your usual haunted house with the interior looking kind of paranormally, is that even a word? To cut a long story short, in the interior I used a lot of the paranormal things, so like the wallpaper and then little bits that came with the pack. Lots of vampire debug as well, with plants and everything. I actually made a TikTok video, so if you have TikTok, you can search Tazkabaz and you'll see a lot of building tips and whatnot over on my TikTok. And I made a video showing all the different things that comes with the pack. Well, I showed some of the build items and I showed Bonehilda and me freaking out over Bonehilda. I mean, it's really interesting actually, because when you're in the game and you start doing the seances and you're summoning the deceased, you know, the lights start turning off, which is kind of cool. And at one point I lost all electricity, which was nuts. It's really interesting though. It's a really, really cool pack. This was me looking for kind of things to put on the outside. So I didn't want to do flowers because I thought like flower bed for the windows, because I wanted it to look more spooky and paranormally and not like alive in as such. So we did graveyards, we got loads of debug plants, loads of dead plants to throw around everywhere. I did take a lot of inspo from the last haunted house that I did. So it does actually look a little bit similar to that, to be honest. I will definitely be very interested to see the gameplay of this and how it kind of adds to The Sims, especially with the new career. So I don't know if I'll do one myself, but I will be intrigued to see others doing some gameplay and seeing what you can investigate and everything. Maybe I will try it. Maybe I'll give it a go at some point. Oh, even watching this back, I just love terrain paint. Never ever forget terrain paint in your builds. Like, if you were putting down a load of plants, or even to go like around the whole edge of the property, terrain paint will literally change it up. It will make it look so much like more realistic. It's so good. It is so, so good. Let me know what you lot are thinking about the pack so far, if you've seen videos on it or if you've got it yourself and you've done a bit of a playthrough. Now we're moving on to the inside, and I had a little bit of a play around trying to decide the floor plan because the shape of this house was a little bit odd. And obviously I did want to use the paranormal, as much of the paranormal stuff back as I could. So a lot of the walls on the interior and a bit of the flooring is I'm not a fan of the flooring for this particular build. I feel like it would work in certain types of build. So I didn't use the flooring as much. I used it upstairs, but I used a vampire flooring. But I did want to use as much as I could to just see how it works and how it adds to a build, I suppose. And as I said, I did not clutter this build as much as I normally would with my builds. So the interior is pretty basic for my standards. Obviously, normally when I do building, it takes me very little time on the exterior. So yeah, this is me choosing like what's going on in the inside. I found it quite tricky choosing lights because I didn't want to do too modern lights. So the ones I chose were like the hanging open light bulb type ones. I also left the two towers on the edges of the build empty. Actually, no, I didn't. I ended up putting a bathroom in one of them. But I ended up leaving the other one empty. I didn't really know what to do with it, so I just thought I'd put some stone in there and just leave it open. I actually had to cut a lot out of this video because I was watching Twitch while I was building this, and I kept getting distracted. So there was a big chunk a minute ago that I had to cut out because I was typing in someone's chat, and I was like, oh right, can't leave that in. The seance table I found actually quite interesting, like the chairs float and everything. You can do a seance with Bonehilda as well, and she gets involved, which is super mad. I love this picture frame, those picture frames that are on the walls, not the like the singular ones, but the one that's got a load of different things on it. I really do like them. I think they're super cool. And the sofas and armchair as well that come with this pack are really, really nice. Very perfect for like old-fashioned style of homes as well. I find that there's a lot in the game for modern builds. So like you've got Tiny Living, you have got Get Famous, a fair amount of like Parenthood, I would say, is somewhat modern to an extent. So I'm always happy to see when there's additions for maybe like more old-fashioned homes like this. I'm really loving the style of the furniture. It's super, super cool. When in doubt, plant it out. Oh no, we are not stopping again, are we? How long did I stop here for? Oh, for crying out loud. Oh no, we're off again. I was gonna cut that out, but I thought, you know what, I just, we've been working on this all night, we'll just leave it. I actually never use a lot of this furniture. I never find the right build to, like the build style that I'm doing. It never really, this furniture never really works with what I'm going for. So I quite enjoyed using some of this as well. I have used some of it before in previous builds, but not any recently. This was me remembering that we needed to add a bathroom. So I chose the tower, one of the tower blocks as the bathroom. I just used like some of the vampire toilet and sink just to have a basic bathroom, not forgetting any toilet paper. I could never ever forget my toilet roll. I put a few of the new flowers and plants in there as well. And then I made a twin bedroom upstairs in the other room. Added a few cluttery bits as well. I put in a little desk. A bookcase also if they want to read. I was going to add a TV to this build, but I thought, you know what, they're going to be hunting all the paranormal things, they ain't got time to watch TV. I really love those suitcases, actually, the suitcase bedside table that I've just placed there. They're super cute. And the curtains as well that came with this pack, they're pretty, pretty cool. I do like them. They've got a fair few unusual swatches as well, but I do like it, I must say. And then I added a few stains and stuff, like a few broken wallpaper and cracks and everything into some of the walls. And there you have the finished haunted house. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, then please hit that like button, pop a comment down below, and subscribe if you want to see more. Take care, and I'll see you next time. Ties out.